Welcome to a special edition of The Inside Voice. Composers and clinicians John Jacobson, Cristi Miller, Rollo Dilworth, and Roger Emerson discuss the joys and challenges of music education, focusing on teacher-student relationships, repertoire, the value of reading sessions, and more.
You each have talked about mentors and influential people in your life. Identify maybe one and give maybe one sentence to describe what that person has done for you.
Kirby Shaw. I mean, Kirby was the one who said, you can do this. And in the final analysis, you know, we talk about teaching literacy and about great music, and ultimately, for all of our students, we want to empower them to be able to do this, which is either music or life or love or whatever it is. And I owe him a deep gratitude for empowering me to move forward.
I would have to say the person that's probably touched me the most is Kathleen Reynolds. She is like a surrogate mother to me in Oklahoma City. She was the Oklahoma Teacher of the Year, not just the music teacher. She was the Oklahoma Teacher of the Year in her time when she was teaching. We became good friends when I moved to Oklahoma City, but she has just taught me that there's music in everything. Did you hear that? There's music in that. And that children are important, and that life has challenges. And so she probably has shaped me more than she'll know. I mean, I should tell her. And we always talk about how important it is to share, but she's been such a great mentor and a good friend, and she still is someone that I count on a lot. So.
And she's in
her... she's 88. Wow. She will be 88. She'll probably kill me for telling you that. But she's so witty, and she's still lady. So with it.
Oh, just show, music keeps you young.
She's just right spot on, so she means a lot to me.
Well, I think for me, it's definitely my very first music teacher, who I talked about, I think, a little bit on another Pepper video, and her name was Johnny Howard Franklin Brown. She had four names, and she had a doctorate. She was Dr. Brown, and she not only said to me, you can do this, she said to me, you will do this. And in those days, as a little boy, little Catholic school choir boy growing up, you obeyed your elders. But I realized as I grew older and older and with her continuing to mentor me that she saw something in me that I was too young at the time to see in myself. And she really wanted me to do my very best and would not accept anything less than my best. And if I were to fail, it was not only a disappointment to me, but it was a disappointment to her. So I never wanted to disappoint her. I didn't really care so much about disappointing myself, but disappointing her. And so, yes, you can and you will do this.
But you've done that for your students too.
I've tried to do that for my students as well. And understand that with every student, you have to say that in a slightly different way. with her, that set things into motion for me. And I've never forgotten it.
But probably the phrase that come back to me would come from my father, superintendent of schools, who at some point early in my adult life, I was probably 17 or 18, looked at me and said, you are enough. Mm-hmm. You don't have to be, you know, you're just everything that you are, the thing that makes you, you, it's enough. And I think to me that was a really valuable lesson to learn for myself, but also to pass along to my students over all these years is that, you know, it's the great thing about the choir, again, here in this choir, we need all of you. No matter what it is that makes you, particularly you, it's enough. And be the best that you can be at that. Yeah. And that was...
You know, that line is in Dear Evan Hansen. You are
yeah,
you,
I know.
And you are enough.
I think they must have talked to my dad.
I think so, too.
I know.
Or somebody heard one of your talks and they've used that.
Right. So teachers watching this video can be that person to inspire one of their students.
Absolutely.
They can...
I hope that helps.
And you will never know the student that you are reaching.
That's true.
You know, the standouts are always the real talented and the troublemakers. Mm-hmm. But there's that quiet one mm-hmm. who is being influenced every day mm-hmm. by you. Don't mm-hmm. forget that.
I'll never forget one of my methods teachers gave me the best piece of advice of going forward and how to approach teaching music. He said, you want to create a great experience for everybody in your classroom because some will become music majors, most will not.
Right.
Most mm-hmm. will go on to become consumers right. of music.
Yeah.
And you never know who's going to be that board member
yeah.
that you're teaching
absolutely.
In the future mm-hmm. that will be the next person to vote on whether or not music gets cut.
Or the doctor taking your appendix out.
You want to make sure that you're
so you want to make
it so you want to make sure. So one of the things I always wanted to do, one of the guiding principles was to create or to have a great experience for every student,
yeah.
no matter what. Yeah.